Hello, hello, my squidlings. It's Katie, and welcome back to another video. Today, I'm going to be doing a review, and I'm going to be taking a look at the Derwent Inktint Pan Set. This is set one of two, and it is well-loved, as you can tell, and I want to talk about it today because I can. Just as a disclaimer, I did buy this with my own money, so all thoughts and opinions and all that stuff is like not being sponsored or anything. I mean, like Derwent, if you want to sponsor me, great, but it's not being sponsored. Today I want to talk about this little pan set, and I'm going to do so in voiceover form, and today I'm going to be painting this cute little moth girl. So yeah, we're going to be painting this with this while I talk about it as well, so let's get started. So the first thing I want to do before I get into the painting is I'm going to swatch them out just to show you all of the different colors. I am swatching them on top of black lines just so you can see a little bit of the opacity. Some of the colors in this set are quite opaque actually, especially if you layer them up, and as you add water to them, of course, they will lose the opacity and they will become transparent. If you don't know what those two terms mean, opacity just basically means that it will cover the black lines, so it'll cover up other paints or whatever, and transparency just means it's see-through. So that was one test I wanted to do, and then I just kind of wanted to show a little bit of the range of color as well, so watering it down just to see how like light and dark, and of course you can definitely go lighter and probably even darker if you layer up, but that is just something I wanted to do. Also, these paints do dry very, very matte. I don't know if it's the formulation in them or not, but they do dry very matte. They're not chalky, but they are matte, if that makes any sense. And they are quite pretty. These are not watercolors, though. I do want to let you know that these are actually ink, and you can layer up subsequent layers without worrying too much about the underneath layers coming up. They will move a little bit, especially if you scrub, but it's not like they're gonna go very far. They're definitely not going to be completely erased because, I don't know about you, but sometimes I've had watercolor layers just kind of dissolve because I added other layers. So here are the swatches, and you can see some of the opacity on the black stripe. And then here's just a couple of little swatches that I did. So this is like all the colors you can mix. Of course, you can mix them darker or lighter, but I just did some really simple swatching, and you can honestly get a lot of colors, and they're really earthy and fun. And they do layer up really well. I didn't go past four layers just because I didn't feel like it, but they do layer up pretty nicely. But overall, so far, this seems to be like a nice, well-rounded palette. I really like the inclusion of this kiwi green here, and I just really like the colors. So anyway, let's go paint something. So while I'm painting this piece, I am going to be talking a little bit about the palette. So this is a set one of two, as I mentioned earlier. They do have a second set, and I actually think you can buy them all in one set as well. But looking over the colors, I think that personally these colors matched my style a little bit more. I would eventually like to get the second set, but it's definitely not necessary. And it's actually pretty inexpensive. This set on Blick retails for $21 US. And you can actually buy the pans individually, which I found really cool. So if you run out of a color, you can just replace it. And they're about $239 US, again, at Blick. I don't know, they may be more or less expensive depending on where you're buying and all that stuff. So yeah, but I just wanted to give a little bit of a price breakdown. I've noticed that the color shift isn't super crazy. It, again, depends on how much water you're using, but this paint doesn't tend to color shift a lot. It will color shift a little bit, and I keep saying color shift. The color will change a little bit between dry time and being wet. So it's not crazy drastic. I find these colors to be really, really vibrant even when dry, which I always like because I don't know about you, but there's nothing worse than putting some paint down and being like, oh my gosh, this is so vibrant and pretty, and then it dries and it is nothing like what you thought it was going to do. I suppose that is what is important about doing a swatch test and all that, but I don't know, sometimes I will swatch my paints out and it still doesn't do what I want it to do. Maybe that's just the definition of insanity, but you know. One thing I think can be kind of frustrating with these paints is layering. So they do layer up, but they hit this point where they won't layer anymore. It's like it's too opaque and you're just layering just like the thickest color upon thickest color. And
it just won't go anywhere anymore. It just doesn't do anything. And it gets kind of, I think when they're really, really opaque, they get a little bit chalky compared to if you water them down. In this piece, I worked in quite a few layers, as you'll see, and I didn't really find a lot of that chalkiness layering up until I hit the really high layers of like the skin and the hair, especially whenever I was layering darker colors. I found those to be a little bit more chalky than the rest of them. And of course, like I mentioned earlier, they are more opaque when they're thick. So it's always a good thing if you want that opacity. Later on in the video, I do add some opacity to certain parts like the eyes just to cover up other areas. And it worked really, really well, even when dry. So I find that to be really nice as well. I do like this pan set. It's a cute little pan set. It comes with a little water brush and sponge, as you can tell. I've not even used the water brush. Just because I have my own and I've not taken it traveling, but it would be a really nice set to take traveling because of its size. It's got a little, you know, it's just perfect for travel. It's got wells, it's small, it comes with a water brush, it's great for travel. For me, this is a pretty well-loved set already. I've used it quite a few times and I haven't regretted it. And every time I make a piece with it, I'm always really happy with it. And I just love the colors that you can actually mix. I do find that there are three greens, and to me that seems a little redundant because you can mix so many greens with the yellow combination of like the blues. If you mix the black with the yellow, you can get a little bit of green. And so I find that having all of these greens in here seems to be a little redundant in my opinion, but if I wanted to, I could just buy a single pan and swap it out. So it's a super easy fix. And again, I think I'm not even sure what colors are in the other set, but maybe they don't have as many greens. I guess I could look that up, but I honestly have no idea. But for me, some of my favorite color swatches that I was actually able to make in this set were some of the blues. They just mixed really well together. And I love that kiwi for mixing the really light green. I think that's probably one of my favorite mixing colors across this. And the plum is my favorite in the palette. It works for a great shadow color, it works for a great line art color, and it just works for a regular great color. It mixes well, it's just an all around great color, and I love it. I feel like it's been forever since I've done a review like this, and I'm just like, it feels kind of weird. But this is the last piece that I'm making for my moth series over on Patreon. I am making prints of this and all of my other moth pieces. There will be 3 prints this month, a chibi sticker, a cute little Luna moth, pin or charm, and then of course a sticker sheet full of 6 stickers. So if you're interested in any of those that are moth themed, there will be a link on the top right of your screen if you want to click that. You can head on over to the Patreon Squid Squad and support me there. You can support me for as little as a dollar. It'll get you access to a bunch of stuff like works in progress and polls, and you can participate in the theme. And if you pledge more, you get more rewards depending on what you pledge, from videos and mini speed paints and stuff to all kinds of stuff. You get prints, stickers, charms, originals every month. It really just depends. But anyway, like I said, if you want to check that out and check out all the rewards, I would super appreciate it. But anyway, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. It was really fun for me to make, and this piece went through a lot of stages for me. I wanted to try out a new style of blending and I really liked it. I had fun. I definitely think I could stand to play around with shadows and lights and learn a little bit more and do some more studies. But I had fun with this piece, and it took a lot of unexpected turns. I was not anticipating having her such like dark skin, and it's not even super dark, but I wasn't anticipating having dark skin. But I really love it. I think it works really well with the color combination, and I wanted the background to be kind of chaotic. So, I don't know. I just feel like the piece really worked all together. Of course, there are some errors, as there are in any art piece, that I could stand to learn from, but I do really enjoy the piece overall, so I hope you do too. Also, one last thing I want to talk about really quick before I end the video is the fact that I have an art store, if you don't know about it. Right now, I have a ton of cute, like, Valentine's and spring-related items, and I think they're super cute, and there's just like stickers, prints, charms. Actually, some of the charms are earrings. So if you want to head on over to the store, there'll be a link on the screen. If you want, you can also take 10% off your order. Unless you're a patron, you have a code, patrons, to get 25% off your order. But if you're not a patron, you can get 10% off your order by using the code Let's Cuddle. I'll put it on the screen. It's Let's Cuddle 10, and it'll get you 10% off. All of the items in this store update, which are all the Valentine's and spring items, will be leaving the store on March 31st. So make sure you get anything that you're interested in before then. So, yeah, and then they'll be leaving for a year, so they won't be coming back till next year, but that's okay, because again, they will be coming back eventually, so if you miss them this time around, that's okay. But anyway, I've been long-winded enough, I apologize for that. I hope this, it's kind of like a review, it's more like an overview, I feel like, of just kind of like my thoughts and opinions on it. I think they're really great and pigmented, and I would recommend these for beginners or for professionals because I love them and I just think they work really amazingly. But anyway, that's just my opinion. I hope that this was informational to you, and I hope that if you're considering buying these or whatever, this helped your decision. Again, I'm not paid or sponsored. All right, I love you all so much. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoyed my long rambles. I'm getting longer, ramblier. What was that? I ramble more now that I've been doing vlogs and these longer format videos, so like, I'm sorry, but I love to talk, so. But anyway, again, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for hanging out with me. If you like videos like these, leave a thumbs up on the video. Also, if you want, leave a comment down below and let me know any future reviews you'd like to see. Maybe I'll buy it. Maybe I already have it. I don't know. I've been hoarding art supplies, so who knows? Yeah, if you are a part of our Cute Squid Pod, there is a subscribe button down below. Also, don't forget, I've got social medias in the description, and you can go follow me on Instagram or Twitter or wherever. And yeah, until next time, my adorable squidlings, toodaloo!